Before that, we all know the feeling after a long, hot tube journey. Dirty and dusty, especially in the summer. But is the pollution in the underground actually dangerous? According to Transport for London, no, it isn't. It says most of the dust is from train brakes and human hair. But not everyone is so sure. Martin Stew went underground to investigate.
We all know that exhaust fumes from traffic can cause high levels of air pollution at street level.
But what about the air that we breathe underground?
More than a billion journeys are made on the tube every year. To ensure the air is safe to breathe, it's checked every day, either on the platforms or on monitors worn by staff.
This dust head monitors very fine dust. The air is drawn in through this brass tube just here. And it's inside there is a cyclone action, which selects the particle sizes. The smaller particles are drawn up to the filter where they're trapped. The large particles fall into this rubber boot here. In this way, we select the very fine particles of dust that are likely to go deep into your lungs.
Samples are weighed and measured against health and safety standards to ensure they're not at dangerous levels.
When you've been on the tube all day and you blow your nose, you get black stuff in the tissue, what exactly is it that we're breathing in down here?
What you're breathing in is iron, and the iron is formed from the friction action of the brakes on the wheels and the wheels on the rails of our tube trains. The other thing that is in the dust is as a result of the number of people who use a tube. So we get a lot of rubbing off of fibres of clothes, of skin scale and of hair.
Overnight, platforms and tunnels are deep cleaned to keep dust levels down, but they never get fully clean. So should we be worried about breathing in lungfuls of skin, hair, clothing and iron?
The dust on the underground is a nuisance, but it is not harmful to health. And we've actually done a lot of research, and we've invited researchers with international reputations to investigate that for us. And they have reassured us that it's highly unlikely to be harmful to health.
Is highly unlikely a good enough assurance, or should more be done?
I've had asthma and I've had it for 6 years, and I cannot use the London Underground because of the amount of dust particles they have and the fact that they don't filter the dust out as much as they should. So it's very hard to breathe down there. You've got the heat, you've got the dust, you've got all those people, and it does trigger my asthma.
For now, the best science says, whilst it may not be pleasant, the tube's dust is probably safe. Martin Stew, ITV News.
And tube passengers at Waterloo were handed free bottles of water this morning to help them deal with the heat. Underground bosses say they're working hard to reduce temperatures by introducing air-conditioned trains and larger ventilation shafts. But in the meantime, they're urging commuters to keep themselves cool.
Obviously, the hot weather in London is continuing. It can get quite uncomfortable on the tube. So this is part of our message to be able to make sure you carry a bottle of water with you. Look after yourself when you're on the tube. And if you do feel unwell, of course, we really think it's important that people get off the train at the station, try and avoid pulling the emergency handle. We've got lots of staff around that can help people.
So is the hot weather set to continue? Martin's back with the weather.